The second inning is inspired by Catholic Charities, invites you to the Dragon Boats Races and Festival. The Battle of the Boats returns to the Inner Harbor on September 9th. Get the details at dragonboatsbaltimore.org. We start the second inning, Orioles and Mets. The Orioles load the bases in the bottom of the first, but can't get anyone home. And Pete Alonso wasn't set to Dean Kramer, so they call a violation against him. So Kramer's in the count 0-1. And the pitch to Alonso is rolled foul up the third baseline. No balls and two strikes. Well, it's 98 Rock Night, so we're pleased to be joined by Justin from Justin Scott and Spiegel. Justin.
Geoff, Melanie, a pleasure.
It is.
Good evening.
It is a
good
pleasure.
Evening. It is so nice to work with two broadcasters that have full sets of teeth. This is lovely.
Pitch is down and away, 1-2.
They're not real.
Look at you
two. We'll tell you that now.
Perfect skin, by the way. I know you're enjoying the broadcast on FM or AM radio. You have no idea. The silkiness of Geoff Arnold's forearms. I want to know your skin regimen.
The 1-2 is hit on the ground. Deep third base. Urias Fields tosses to first. And they get Alonso for out number one. I actually just prefer eating a lot of hot dogs.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
That sounds good.
It's hot dog water. That's all it is.
Melanie, confirm it or deny a little rumor floating around the station. You could bench press 225 for 15.
I can squat 225 for 15. I don't know about press.
I'm going to agree to disagree. Those shoulders are looking like absolute bowling balls of pure muscle and intimidation. What a beautiful night here at Orioles Park, Camden Yards. Me sandwiched between excellence.
Oh, you're so kind. As the first pitch is taken for a knee-high strike by Geoff McNeil. Nothing, nothing, second inning. All right, Justin,
let's make that a shirt.
He's not here to defend himself, so give me a couple of Brett Hollander stories, please.
Brett Hollander has a very interesting gait. If you've ever noticed, we like to call it,
ground ball, third, diving pickup, Urias from his knees, thrown to first, stretched by Mountcastle, and they get McNeil for out number two.
Absolutely beautiful. You'll see the way that that gentleman ran across first base. That's very similar to how Brett Hollander walks, except Brett Hollander does not move his torso from the waist up.
We've actually talked about this before. I'm so glad you're chiming in on this.
He looks like Michael Flatley from Riverdance. It's absolutely amazing. Also brushes his teeth 7 times a day. The freshest breath at 3800 Hooper Avenue.
Do you also know that Brett Hollander is a big-time soup guy?
Really?
Big soup guy.
Like a two-bowl of soup a day kind of guy.
That guy loves a meal you can drink
we call
or a
him
drink you can
Brett.
Eat. Two-soup Brett. Old Progresso Hollander, we call him. Extra chunky. Does he like it New York or Boston style? We don't know, but I will tell you what. You can smell him coming before you see him. Wow, there we go. He gets a piece of that foul ball right side of the field. That's probably not how it's said, but here we are.
That's actually not bad of play-by-play.
I appreciate it.
We're going to have to keep you for another
half inning.
All right, 0-2,
two outs. Here, come on. Call this next one to Starling Marte. Come on.
All right, Starling Marte. There he goes. There's the pitch. Ooh, just a little bit outside. Tricks him. He is walking that off, acting like he's not embarrassed. Is that Big League Chew or Bubblicious? We're waiting for the call from the field. Okay, we've gotten confirmation. That is Big League Chew Strawberry. Big League Chew Strawberry. Twice the sugar, half the flavor. Yep, that is not the type of bubblegum your Baltimore Orioles are going to be chewing. That's why the Mets right now are struggling this season. Bad bubblegum choices. Melanie, what's your bubblegum of choice?
Well, we've got to send it to break, but I will tell you mine as soon as we come back. It is heading to the bottom of the second inning. No score, Orioles and Mets on the Orioles Radio Network.
First pitch is a strike into Ramon Urias, 0-1. Bottom of the second inning, nothing between the Orioles and the Mets. David Peterson delivers, and he pumps in strike two at the knees. Geoff Arnold, Melanie Newman, and because it is 98 Rock Night, Justin from Justin Scott and Spiegel.
Absolutely a pleasure. When we were last joining you, Melanie, you're going to tell us your gum of choice.
It's fouled back by Urias, 0-2.
I'm a little off the grid. It's Big League Chew, but I like the cotton candy.
Oh, that's why they call you cotton candy eyebrows, and that's why they call Geoff old Mr. Velvet Knuckles over here. That's right.
I think I'm going to hold on to that
soft,
one.
Soft, tender digits as Peterson eyes his catcher. You could tell the catcher skipped leg day. Big upper body.
And there's a roller out to the left side. It's scooped up by Lindor. Throws in the move to first. Close play. Out.
Out.
Big stretch by Pete Alonso over at first base. And it looked like he held the bag. So one out in the bottom of the second. All right, so you guys, and I don't want to blow smoke, but you guys seriously do maybe one of the best morning shows in the country.
Thank you, Geoff.
Justin Scott Spiegel. So what makes your chemistry? How do you guys do what you do at the level in which you do it every morning?
Hot yoga. Adderall, and a ton of self-doubt. That's right. Some really good therapy, a lot of handshakes, and many trips to the human resources department, and being able to work with amazing people like you.
First pitch is outside to the former Met, James McCann, 1-0.
Geoff, this is why you and I do Pilates together. This makes sense. This all ties in with on-air chemistry.
We actually, just in our first road trip of the year, the 1-0 pitch is taken high for ball two. We actually went to do Pilates, and she talked me into doing it. And have you ever done something that you regret in, like, the first 30 seconds in which you're trying to do it?
Fell in love. First thing. Falling in love.
2-0 gets a swing and a miss.
The minute I gave my heart away, I said, you know what, this was a big mistake.
I hope she's not listening.
No chance.
But we actually did Pilates. Have you ever done Pilates before?
I have, and I don't have the limberness for it. Now, oh, there we are. Melanie, more Pilates or the hot yoga type?
I'm more Pilates. I don't need Baltimore is hot enough outside. Mm. I don't need it inside.
Yeah, a hot yoga class will really work up a nice funk. You'll be able to tell pretty quickly who uses deodorant and who doesn't.
The 2-2 pitch is outside, sending it to a full count. Yeah, I wore my deodorant and it stopped working about 30 seconds in.
Yeah, I tell you, a little Bikram yoga in the summertime. It's going to smell like low tide right around Bethany Beach. It is bad news. A couple of gentlemen in there that have not showered properly in a few days. You got to breathe through your mouth, so use a little bit of that mint spread under your nose.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, boy.
It is not good.
Uh-oh. 3-2 pitch. McCann bounces it up the third base line, and it'll be grabbed up by Brett Beatty. Nothing in the bottom of the second. Justin is with us from Justin Scott and Spiegel. By the way, where is Spiegel? He did the last year, he did the This Land Is Your Land with the music stand and everything.
And he does send his regards and apologies. Was going to be here tonight. He got cataract surgery on each eye.
Oh, boy.
He got each lens replaced.
3-2 pitch is outside for ball four. It gets off the glove of the catcher, Alvarez. And McCann is on base. What is already the third walk by David Peterson.
So we were talking about Brett's stories here a moment ago before this game sped up on us. I do have to tell you, personal tragedy struck him in Toronto.
Really?
He was walking 10 blocks back from this new place he had found. I had sent him there. He loved their soup. He got all the way to his hotel door, and they had packaged it wrong, and the soup went everywhere. And he was a wreck. We got a text about it immediately.
No.
They gave him a free one the next day, but it was a really bad day.
That is a shame.
Bunted foul by Ryan McKenna. And you know what was also hilarious about it? The maid was in the room. There was a maid cleaning his room, and as he comes in with the soup spilling, it officially just goes onto the floor, and the maid is there.
Her day is done. The next thing you know, she's got a broccoli cheddar oil spill on her hands.
Correct.
Fun fact about Brett, have you guys ever seen him swim in a pool or at the beach?
No.
Incredibly fast, webbed toes.
Webbed toes.
Geoff, you went to college with this man. How did you not know that?
I mean, I didn't share, like, bunk beds or anything with Brett, though.
This guy could be in an Aquaman sequel. It is great. We call him the Torpedo.
The 0-1 pitch. That's a ground ball headed to second base. Fielded by McNeil. Lindor to first. Like a torpedo. That's a double play. 4-6-3. Peterson faces the minimum in the second. And the Orioles, I think, are going to take a look just to be sure. And they are not going to challenge this. Justin, you guys are three of the best in the country at what you do. It was so much fun to spend a full inning of baseball with you, and I hope you enjoyed doing your little bit of play-by-play, too.
Geoff, Melanie, an absolute pleasure to work with two legendary pros like you guys. Thank you so much.
You are the best, man.
I appreciate it.
That is Justin from Justin Scott and Spiegel, 98 Rock Night at the ballpark. Nothing, Orioles and Mets. We go to the third on the Orioles Radio Network.